Right now, all over Baltimore, people are engaging in illegal but commonplace video gambling. It happens in bars and small stores, a few machines that the owner pays out cash under the table, but the state is looking to shut them down. 11 News reporter John Sherman is live in the studio. He has an inside look at the sting. John?
Well, Rod, when the comptroller's office teamed up with the city police to bust a convenience store with an illegal video gaming system late last week, 11 News was there.
Police first gather out front, then move in, making sure to document what they find in detail. At this West Baltimore convenience store, these machines have been caught paying out cash.
We had an undercover officer that came in and saw that they had, this establishment had gaming machines and were paying out.
City police say the owner of the store was in court that same day as this bust on an earlier similar charge. They also say as soon as police entered, the owner took out this stack of $20 and $100 bills and tried to stash it in a trash can and then cover it over. Operations like this can net $4,500 per week per machine.
We're here to make sure that this kind of illegal operation, it does not continue.
We see the machines and we take action.
Jeff Kelly heads up the comptroller's compliance division. He says illegal video gaming can often be tied to other crime and crime networks, but that liquor license laws give his office needed leverage.
These machines are illegal and they're being operated many times in liquor establishments. It gives us unique interest. When somebody tries to get a liquor license, they say they're going to operate that business lawfully. And part of that is not having these games that are illegal.
Police say illegal video gambling often goes hand in hand with the sale of untaxed illegal cigarettes. So whenever they find one, they always check for the other. Reporting live, John Sherman, WBAL-TV 11 News.